Will the world's thinnest smartphone survive my tests? In front of me, I have the Moto Z, the world's thinnest premium smartphone from Motorola. I've tested close to 30 phones now. It's important to understand how durable your device is when you buy it. Is the screen plastic, like the Galaxy S7 Active, or would it catastrophically crumble under pressure, like the Nexus 6P? After watching my tests, you'll know what to look out for when using your own phone. This phone is so thin, there is hardly even room for the USB-C charging port on the bottom. For comparison, my Galaxy S7 Edge is on the top at 7.9mm, then the Moto Z in the middle at 5.2, and the iPhone 6 on the bottom with 6.9. We'll start with the scratch test. These picks tell us where the screen falls on Mohs scale of hardness. Most phones reach a level 6 before scratching. Some phones have a plastic screen, like the Droid Turbo 2 or the Galaxy S7 Active. The Moto Z has Gorilla Glass 4 on it, so it's no surprise that it lasts until level 6 before scratching. You won't have to worry about keys or coins scuffing up the glass of this phone. The front 5-megapixel camera lens is integrated into the Gorilla Glass 4, so it won't be scratching either. But we do have a front-facing flash on this phone, which is awesome for the weirdos who like taking selfies in the dark. It is made of plastic, but that's normal and nothing to worry about. The earpiece seems to be made of metal. The only problem is that it's a wide open gaping hole, shaped like a cheese grater, just waiting to fill up with pocket lint and makeup or little rocks from the beach. So watch out for that. The fingerprint scanner is not made of glass or sapphire like the iPhones or the HTC 10, so it does scratch. But even after being heavily scratched by my razor blade, it would still function about 75% of the time. So as long as you keep the scratching to a minimum, it will continue to function just fine. The sides of this phone are made of metal, no primer or plastic to be found. Even the side buttons are made of metal. So far we've seen some pretty quality materials. There is a glass panel on the top and bottom of the Moto Z. I imagine that this is where the screws are hidden, and we'll find out during my teardown video. I'll review this tech from the inside if the phone survives my durability test. The camera lens is made of glass, so it will not be scratching easy like the plastic lens of the BlackBerry Priv. Do you see how the dual flash at the bottom is different colors? Having a multicolored flash allows for more realistic, less washed out pictures in the dark. The iPhones have a dual colored flash, as well as the HTC 10, but the Galaxy S7 does not. So if you are a photography person who uses the flash, now you know. Thumbs up for the premium features nobody usually talks about. It's the little things that make a smartphone good. The camera hump on this phone is pretty huge. It makes the hump on the Galaxy S7 Edge look non-existent. If you're the type of person to use the Moto mods, like the projector, the battery pack, or the speakers, they'll cover up that hump with the added thickness of the backpack. The ring is made of metal and won't flake or discolor if you don't end up using the mods. Here is where the mods connect. The gold points themselves seem solid. There is a little rubber ring around each one to keep them clean and dust free. So I don't see any immediate issues with this particular component. The back panel is made of a very thin piece of metal, so the construction of the phone does have that premium feel to it. Onto the flame test. It's always interesting to me to see how long the display holds up to the extreme heat. I left the flame in place for over 50 seconds, almost one full minute, before the screen started reacting to the heat from my lighter. Pretty impressive considering that my Galaxy S7 only lasted 15 seconds before the pixels turned permanently white. The phones are cool to the touch within seconds of the flame being removed. Onto the bend test. I was extremely nervous about the world's thinnest phone breaking, but instead of snapping like chocolate, it just flexed like the world's most expensive banana and sprung back to its original position like it was no big deal. Not even a kink near the power button, which would be normal for a metal smartphone like the iPhone 6. Even bending from the opposite direction yielded no carnage, unfortunately. There was a small leftover bend, but that could be easily corrected. I'm impressed that Motorola can manufacture the thinnest smartphone in existence and still have it be durable. While I do not endorse sitting on your cell phone, at least now we know that it will not catastrophically fail taking all of your data with it, like the Nexus 6P or the Nexbit Robin. If you're not subscribed yet, make sure you do it. It is free, and you will be notified every time I test a new phone. You'll be upgrading your own device someday, and it's better to know beforehand what you are getting into. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you around.